Yes!
Excited.
Yeah!
So we got a late start, so we are now going to play Scene Three Ways. The way this works is two people are going to come up here, they're going to get a suggestion for you. They're going to do a short 2-minute scene, a short 30-second scene, very simple, almost no emotion, and then they're going to get three suggestions from you for like genres, a style in which you want them to redo the scene, and they're going to do it three ways. Thus, Scene Three Ways.
Can I have a relationship between us two?
Brother.
Sister.
Thank you, brothers.
We didn't get a problem. Something wrong.
Something wrong?
No, we didn't get a problem. Conflict.
Maybe I have a conflict between me and Mom.
Hey, bro!
Cool bike. Mom got you that too?
Yeah.
Look at mine. Mine's got hydraulics on it.
I just got it right
there. You're on the pad last year.
You know they're giving out free crack samples over here, right?
Oh, bro? Free? Free? You can watch my bike room?
Sure, of course.
Thanks.
And sing.
And see, steals the bike. Okay, how would you want this scene redone in a genre? Hopefully, you know what that word is from English class. Now, what style?
Martial arts.
Thank you. Western. Western.
The same scene done in Western.
You know what, they're giving out free samples over there.
Free samples? Drop my bike?
Okay. I hold for it for you.
Drop, bro, drop!
Psych, gotcha.
another style. South Western, anything?
Martial arts.
Matrix. Hey bro,
how you doing?
Look at my new bike.
That's a nice bike.
It has hydraulics.
That made me go boom. I wish I had a bike like that.
But you don't.
Giving out free samples.
They do. Would you watch my bike for me?
Of course.
Thank you.
Three. Alright, one more, right? Two? One more.
Thank you,
Bomber.
Yeah.
What?
horror, scary movie.
Time!
Movies and about 3 seconds and go. Time, moving in 1 second.
I can't feel my legs.
That was Scary Movie 2. Next, everyone, line up. Real quick, freeze. Could I have two up?
Yeah, exactly.
This game is called Freeze. We usually play this every show or so. Get some play up on here as long as no one gets hurt. And the way it works is two people are going to start a scene based on whatever suggestion you guys give us. And they're going to begin the scene. And whatever physical position they are in, someone from the wall is going to yell, freeze. And they have to step forward and take their exact position, but come up with a completely different scene. You'll see how it's played. Could we have a type of an activity? Any activity?
Ballet dancing.
Ballet dancing? Thank you.
Oh, yes.
All right. And the activity and the activity changes that I've seen. And we're going to start off with ballet dancing.
Come, let me teach you. Freeze. Don't turn your back on me, Scar.
What the?
Oh, oh, Simba! Simba!
Something to a department store. Who knows what kind of store it is? Who knows what he's returning? Could someone shut the back door? Anyone? Shut the back door? Just to make sure he's truly silent. Could somebody answer the phone too? Thanks, Wade. So, return department, here he goes. I need a clerk. Is that phone? And manager. Okay, here we are. This is the clerk. He's going to return this guy. This is the manager. Could I have, what's going to happen is he does not know what he's returning. He's going to come back in, and through hints and conversation here, he's going to hopefully, by the end of the scene, figure out what he's returning. Not so loud. Could I have an object that, any object that one might return to anywhere?
True religion, James.
Anything. Thank you. I heard cheese.
Cheese.
Okay. All right. So, Dwayne is going to enter and return some cheese. Could someone, I thought I could hear. I'll go out and get him.
Yo.
Ladies and gentlemen, the game is return the partners. Teams.
Hey, how you doing? Why? What's wrong with it?
It's not working.
To me, it's not working.
It stopped working.
What did you do with it? Let me see. Show me what you did.
All right. What I did with it. Town. Sit on it. And it just isn't making my, feel comfortable.
Ew. It didn't leave a stain?
Should it?
Depends.
Come on, man. Go get me a manager. Cause,
Martin!
Woo-hoo!
I have a problem.
What is your problem?
This thing ain't working.
Well, I don't believe it's supposed to work. You're supposed to do something with it. How did you use it, sir?
Well, how many times do I have to do this? I took it, put it on the ground, and I sat on it. And it just isn't making
it feel comfortable. You're supposed to use it, and then it comes out.
I think it didn't come in a manual. Can you show me how
it comes with directions on the package?
It did?
You take it, you can put it in many things.
Well, I forgot my glasses and I can't see, can you show
me? You can get a grater and go like this. That's what we do in my native country.
A grater?
These rap artists nowadays say they have a lot of it in their pockets.
Do you have a grater?
We don't sell that grater.
You don't sell a grater? How can you sell cheese and no grater?
We have an expert on a talk show where her lady go hands expert. So two chairs forward and one table. Special hands. It's a talk show. Could I have, who is our expert today?
I am the expert.
He is the expert. Could I have a topic on which this man would be an expert?
No.
Anything.
Jesus Christ. Jesus.
Thank you. I heard marbles. Y'all need to yell out more.
What?
All part of the show. Marbles. Suggestions. Go. What's he an expert on?
Cookies.
Cookies. Thank you. That's more like it. He's an expert. He's an expert on cookies. He is the host. With that said, enjoy the show.
Yes.
Hi, we're live back at Corporation. Yes. And we're here with our next group. What's your name, sir?
Pillsbury.
Pillsbury Doughboy. Can I poke your tummy?
Sure.
We have you on the show today because basically we want to see what you can do.
Okay, I get it.
So, what do you do when you're kneading the dough? Can you show me how you knead the dough?
Well, I pick it up like this.
Okay.
And then I squeeze it because it has to be spongy tight.
Oh, okay.
Then I pat it down like patty cake. You know the game.
Yeah. Sure, can we play like a quick version of
that? Let's go.
Sorry, folks.
Ready?
Okay.
Patty cake.
Can you explain what's the effect on your stomach after you eat the cookies?
Well, in the back of my directions, it says to eat carefully.
Yes.
You can lose up to 120 pounds while eating cookies.
What?
Don't be alarmed. Don't be alarmed, honey. Please don't.
What if I give it to my two-year-old son?
She'll love it.
My son?
I heard a couple things about your son, so. The cookies make you 120 pounds, and they're only sold at stores named Target.
Sorry, folks. Back to the questions. What do you think is the most equivalent ingredient? Your cookies.
I have to say,
What? Did you know caramel,
Martha?
Slaves make caramel. We can use caramel?
I think you're overacting.
Why?
Yeah, I'll take that from you.
You better give my water back.
Don't you ever do that. Okay. Hold on. Let's act like adults.
Fine.
Grown women adults.
One more final question.
Okay.
Because you're ridiculous.
Hey, don't touch that. It's no good for you.
One more funny question.
One more?
When you were a child, how many times did you doo-doo? After eating your disgusting cookies.
Hold on.
Yes, I said it. I had like 6 of them yesterday.
Oh,
nasty.
Oh, no.
Yes, I
said it.
I kick you off the show faster than I kick Michael out of his children's place.
No, that's not working. So watch yourself.
Damn, you gave those cookies to kids, you sugarhead.
I can't believe you right now. I cannot be here in this environment. Is this, you live here?
No.
Hey!
You know what? Security! Can you please escort him? You know what? Give me 60 push-ups.
Alright. You know, it's great. A talk show with Martha, but we also have another type of show, a poetry show, where there are some amazing poets, but unfortunately they don't speak English, therefore they have some translators. So if we could just forget about the decoration and that, who cares? So let's set up for next game. It's called Poets' Corner. So two poets in a poetry slash coffee shop are going to battle. Neither one speaks English. Poets, hosts, translator. Y'all forget, hosts. Jermaine and Albie are poets. Translators are Brian and
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to my wonderful poetry cafe. You know it, baby? Now today, we have two of the world's most renowned poets. Over here, we have...
Who's dying?
Kung Pao.
And his translator...
Brian.
And on the other side, we have...
Put him in!
And his translator...
Jeffrey.
Today, both of these poets are going to recite poems based on a topic from the audience. Now, may I have a topic from the audience?
What is
it?
World War!
Thank you. I said thank you. He's going to recite a poem about the projects.
I grew up in the hood. I was beat on plenty of times. Until I could brought the wrong one.
Had a thing die. But a stone die. Sara Kindo.
I met
Faisal Vito.
I met 50 cents.
Say don't good die.
He shot me 10 because he got shot 9.
I thought in time you come to
the roof is on fire. We don't need no water. Pray to God. To get out of the hood.
Now, can I have another topic from my next on ice. Now we will decide whose poem was better. Give it up for
projects.
Or on the other side,
ice.
Now, which one do you like better? Ice? Give it up for or projects.
This game we are playing is Walkout. We're trying to see some shows. About three or four games and more are all new games, so we're trying to keep it fresh for you guys. So, Walkout goes like this. Each of these three people, Jermaine, Jasmine, and Brian, are going to have a trigger word. They're going to do a scene. Anytime their trigger word is set, for instance, if his trigger word is pickle, if he's on stage, he has to come up with a reason to get off stage. If he's off stage, he has to come up with a reason to get back on stage. And it's not to make sense. He can't just walk on and off. So, with that said, could I have a trigger word? Any word that you're thinking of right now? Thank you. Herb. Next word.
Monkey.
Thank you. Monkey and purr.
Can I have a scenario?
Fighting.
Kind of a non-geographical place. You know what? I know where to find one of those at. Let me go get you one.
Yo, you about to let Rob do your hair?
Yeah, I heard he was good, girl.
That dude ain't good.
What is he? A monkey?
He's bad. Yo, if you gonna let him do your perm, you bad off.
Man, I got this new perm. I'll hook you up so much you look like, you know. Just
Beyonce? Maybe not.
It's gonna burn a little bit.
Okay.
But you know what? They tested this stuff on monkeys, and the monkeys liked it. They loved it.
You know, they wanted you back in the bathroom.
What?
I don't know. It was Keisha and the Nene.
They did?
Yeah.
Keisha and the Nene still ain't fixed my pop.
Rob,
I'm coming. Oh. Get the Vaseline, girl.
You know what? Why not?
Because he was just talking about you when you went out.
He was talking about me?
Yeah, he said, I don't know why I always go to Rob and get my perm. Like,
I'm a fucker.
He said, yo, wait, Rob. He said, perm's like.
Oh, okay.
I was like, come to me.
Yeah, monkey's uncle. I'm gonna kick him in the face.
See, back then, eat pie, I don't care.
Yeah, girlfriend, that's why I whooped her. Whoop her. She don't know me.
Move.
move nowhere.
Why not?
I see you like that. You look like a monkey.
Get the po-po! I ain't afraid of po-po!
You look like a monkey, I'm telling you.
I think that gets his head.
I think he look like a monkey.
You were supposed to come in here and get your hair done. You look worse looking you came in here.
I realize that, girl. I like a monkey.
You look bad.
You don't look like no monkey.
Finish this perm!
You know what? I'm done with you.
I was wrong.
I'm done. No.
Why finish doing this perm?
How much you gonna pay me?
I thought it was a free day.
No, you monkeys, I'm done.
You ain't wash that out. I'm snitching.
You know what? Take you and your perm out of here.
You know what?
You know what? Take you and your perm out of here.
You know what? I'm gonna take you out of here. Let's go. Let's get it on.
See. All right. Couple more games. We got and also know a time glance. Whoever's playing time glance. Brian, Ali, and Ralph. Can I have a big event that takes place in someone's life?
Ali Grove.
Two of them, I heard graduation and birth. Okay, having a baby and graduation. Makes what is big graduation? Graduation is the event. What's going to happen is they're going to do the event as it is, and then you guys are going to give me five times before and after. It could be a minute before, it could be 18 years before, it could be 20 years after. So, could you call out some times for me?
10 years.
10 years before?
Ten years
after.
18.
3 years
before.
3 years before?
2 seconds after. Before. 9 months earlier.
9 months earlier?
2 seconds.
All right, no problem. What else?
3 days ago.
I got 10 years, 3 years, 9 months ago. After.
5 minutes, 2 minutes before.
Day after
10.
5 minutes.
5 minutes.
5 minutes.
Wait later.
10 minutes
after.
That night.
I got 5. All right.
She said that night. You got that?
9 months earlier. 3 years before, 10 years after, 10 minutes after, 7 years after, and I'm going to add one, let's go,
that night.
15 years before. What they're going to do is start a scene, I'm going to call out one of these times. Instantly, they have to go into that time, whatever it may be. So, ladies and gentlemen, the event is graduation.
You tight. I'm doing it, I'm graduating! About time, took me 15 years, I told you! Thank you! You're gonna still be in this school, I'm gonna be gone. Making money, we gonna be balling.
9 months, freeze! Sorry, 9 months earlier.
Kevin! Oh my God!
Hey, what are you two doing hugging in the hallway?
I'm practicing when I graduate. In 9 months from now.
I'm not graduating.
You wanna bet?
He's gonna graduate.
That's right. If you luck with your homie, you bet I would've whooped your butt. Now hold up.
Hold back. Don't hit him.
If you touch me,
put
again,
your finger
you
away.
Diploma.
What?
And that's final.
Nigga, please!
Freeze! 10 minutes after graduation.
Hey, I got a surprise for you. You got your diploma. Come on.
Freeze! 3 years before graduation.
Oh.
Hey, young man, what are you doing in the hallway?
Leave me alone. Hey, leave me alone! God! That's too tight for you anyway. I'm pestering you. I can't wait to get out of here. You get on my nerves.
It's time for detention in the lab with me.
Mr. Franklin, no!
Please. 10 years after.
Daddy, you ain't paying no child support.
I'm sorry.
Daddy,
I'm sorry.
No.
Talk to your mother. Talk to your mother.
You graduated and you ain't paying no child support.
You're just like your mother. You're your cross-dresser.
You know what? You know what? It's not successful.
Hey, yo, you look good, girl. You want to play with my hat?
Sure. My daddy wears a hat, too. And him and my mommy go in the room.
Freeze! 70 years after graduation.
I told you! Ah! Oh.
We had you write down some stuff
that
we
missed.
Alright, the next scene is called Fortune Teller. Some of you have seen this before. Change it up a little. We asked you. We asked you earlier to write some questions on the yellow slips and write some sentences on the blue slips. So hopefully you read the little disclaimer about not writing anything. They're trained to only pick up certain ones. So the people are going to come on to this fortune teller and ask a question that's burning inside them, which you wrote, and she is going to answer their fortune and send them on their way, picking up one of the blue slips, your sentences you wrote. She has to make sense somehow, however the blue slip, how it connects and answers their question. Ladies and gentlemen, fortune teller.
All right, who wants to come and get their answers? The question is easy.
I just got locked up.
I can see that.
Yeah. Let me answer my question. How many questions I get? 6 or 7?
Just ask the question.
Who was the first class clown?
Who was the first class clown?
Yeah, you heard me, I said it. Who's the first class clown?
I like food. The is PM. What?
Now you know that you don't know me. How can you help me?
I like food that is BM. Because I am BM class master.
Oh, so you was the first class clown?
Be right.
You laughed at my mother in the first show. I was gonna kill you.
You break yourself. What?
What you
gonna do? With this. Let's go. Let's go.
Break
yourself.
Break
yourself.
I'm gonna get you out.
Why do I smell like
rotten eggs?
Oh, shut up.
Why do you smell like rotten eggs?
Mm-hmm. That's the question.
It hurts when I yawn. It hurts when I yawn because you smell like rotten eggs. You smell transfer to my mouth. And it hurts. I'm in pain. So get out! Who next?
My name is Mickey.
And mine is Nikki.
AKA PJ.
AKA Strawberry.
Yeah.
Right.
some Aspen? What you want, Aspen? You got some Aspen? $6. $6 for you, cuz what is that? A boom ring or what? Is that a safety pin? You got the emergency button on the train? What's that, a parachute? Let me see that. What's your question? You got a question? What's your question? How many questions you got? What you got? How many questions you got? Get a holler. Please, get a holler. How many questions you got? What's your question? Say your question. I want to hear that question. I got a bum in your face. His shoes is tight. I don't know what they are. They look like the third rail. I was about to walk on his foot. I said, oh, let me not get electrocuted. Please let me get the question.
How many eggs in
the
baker's dozen?
I don't know, but I know that. Let me see what the fortune tell me. You know what? I fell off the chair so I couldn't count. But you know what? I think they put like 6 eggs in there because it's so sweet and so tender. You go, oh, what's that store? Like, they put crack in their stuff. What's them donuts store again? They put crack in their stuff. Don't go buy it. Go to Dunkin' Donuts and get some 6 packs of donuts. And they got eggs and they got cheese. All right? All right, thank you. Alright, next.
Shut up, come on. Come
and
give it to. Come and give it to.
Don't hold me.
Come on, come. Shut up, Bob.
Can I get your autograph? I want that autograph. Do that.
Hold me. Hold my hand.
Come on. Wait it time, cool.
Shut up.
I have a question. I can't ask you a question.
Question.
You have a baby dude.
Baby dude. Wanna know?
I wanna know when the baby's gonna come.
Let me see. Let me ask my question. Let me get a question.
Hey, don't you wanna rub my baby? It's good luck.
Don't touch me, son. Let me see when the baby's gonna be due. I never lost my virginity and I'm 40. You know what? I wouldn't even know. Because I never had a baby and I never had a woman. I'm only 40 and I'm a virgin.
Break up! Break up! Oh, yeah. Break up!
Check it out. Hopefully it'll be during school so everyone can come join us. If you haven't bought a ticket, Monday, they're competing against 3 other high schools for the Comedy Improv Theater Sports Championship of New York. Who has a ticket? One person.
I do.
One, that's, she has a ticket, that person has a ticket.
My phone.
That person's ticket is on hold. 4 tickets, now we have 20. And I've actually sold 5 of them. So I have about 10 tickets left. So. Next game we are going to play here in a long time is gonna skip it. It's gonna be on. We'll play it next time. The other is so that you feel like you didn't write for a waste, you wrote down some jobs. Everyone line up. World's Worst is the name of the game. I'm going to call out a profession that you wrote down here. They're going to step forward, whoever wants to do it, and one or a few people are going to do the world's worst version of the job. First one, world's worst correction officer.
I'm going to tell you how to spell smoke. It's S-M-I-K-E.
Spike.
Come here, Michael. Come here, Michael. Come here, Michael. Michael Jackson, I'm not talking to you.
Oh, crap.
Listen, Michael.
No.
Did you do it with that kid?
No.
You did?
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah.
You did? Nasty, Mike. Nasty, Mike.
Get up! The turtle! Ray! Ray!
There is, you know, world's worst snake charmer.
Who? What?
Guess we'll have to wait for Chantel since she's really
I'm coming! Wait!
Oh God, no! No!
Just keep whistling, just keep whistling.
World's worst.
Oh, my snake.
I'm Voldemort.
World's worst. Worst window washer.
I'm a window shopper, man. I think I know why.
World's worst doctor. World's worst doctor.
Anybody.
Rowdy. World's worst hair transplant surgeon.
Oh, hair transplant surgeon.
World's worst hairstyles.
Rowdy.
Hair. As you can see the naps. Oh my god. Let me braid your hair. How do you cornrow? Cornrow. Oh my god. Is that with three braids or seven? Oh my god.
I will make your hair look just like mine.
Yeah, I did it, Aunt.
World's worst yard man.
What's a yard man? Me name Fun Rose.
Lawyer, attorney.
Yeah, that's why
I'm the man.
World's worst fireman.
I'll get you, Spider-Man!
World's worst dentist.
Anybody?
World's worst teacher.
Hello, I'm Mr. Shipley. My pants are very tight. I cannot breathe.
Mr. Frankie, for the last time, I don't know what to do with this schedule.
I'm gonna catch up to you. I'm gonna get you.
World's worst crackhead.
Oh!
I sell myself to you. I sell myself to you for a dollar. Please, let me get a dollar. Holla, please.
World's worst farmer.
We're gonna use natural human manure instead of horse.
Now that.
That's obviously not a weed tree. That's a herbivore. You can eat that.
Where's my hole?
Right here!
Alright, we're gonna finish the show here. I need your help. When I point to you or if I point near you, could you call out an object? Anything that comes to mind, I don't care if it's a food, a color, anything. So, the first time they've ever done this in a show, it's called Pile of Dead Clowns. It's the name of the game. So, think of an object. Everyone got an object in your head? It could be a weird one. What? From paperclip to giraffe, I don't care. Everyone got one, so if I point to you, you can yell out. All right. Their job, once they hear what you say, is to step forward. Once they hear what you say, they step forward and they do a creative death, fall on the floor, and by the end, they should all be piled up as a pile of dead clowns. So, water bottle, death by water bottle.
Hold up.
Trace, happy birthday!